Stay tuned for a special sports edition of Burbank Magazine, The Battle for Burbank 2000. And the battle begins right now.
Peter Masurlian here, Memorial Field, ground zero for the Battle for Burbank 2000.
Yes! Yes! All right! Let's play football now! You gotta get off of them! You know the play's gone! Get off of them and get up!
I'm sure you remember our sports documentary last year on the Burbank Burroughs crosstown rivalry. Burbank Magazine highlighted the big game of 1999, but also presented a retrospective of the crosstown clashes of the 20th century, starting with Burbank High's win in 1949. Burroughs won 32 of those games last century. The Bulldogs prevailed in 19. And having survived the anticipated apocalypse of Y2K, we're now able to sort of start fresh in the new century. And who would win the first game of the 21st century? And more dramatically, the first game of the new millennium? To get that answer, we'll start in the preseason.
The Burbank Bulldogs ended up at 2-3, while the Burroughs Indians finished their non-league play at 1-4. Burbank Magazine made a trip over to the Glen Oaks Boulevard offices of our twice-weekly local newspaper and asked Burbank Leader's sports editor, Jeff Tully, to size up our two local teams as they headed into Foothill League play against the perennially strong squads of the Santa Clarita Valley.
You know, their schedules have been really tough in non-league, and so, you know, the wins may be being a little hard to come by, but, I mean, hopefully that's going to pay off once league hits. Well, the top two teams, I mean, Hart and Valencia, I mean, you probably, you know, not to knock the local teams, but, you know, you just try to stay close to teams like that. Both teams have been ranked consistently, you know, top in the top five in CIF. From that, it falls off. Saugus, you know, is a decent team. And then Canyon is really down. I'd say, you know, if teams want to steal wins in the Foothill League, Canyon's probably the team.
Well, in week one of Foothill League play, the Burroughs Indians had a chance to take on the presumed weakest team from the Santa Clarita Valley, the Canyon High Cowboys, in a Wild West atmosphere that included a chain gang cowgirl and cowboy boots. It didn't look good early when a Lawrence Salmon pass intended for Keith Jarbo was deflected, then picked off by the Cowboys' Ricky Galvin. But later, with 2:16 to go in the first quarter, Salmon connected for 33 yards to Jonathan Overturf, who made a diving catch at the Cowboys' 5, setting up a 5-yard Bobby Mendoza touchdown run as the Burroughs Indians took a 6-0 lead. Then Cowboy Ron Leonbach ran the wrong pass pattern and had the ball bounce off his back and into the hands of Burroughs linebacker Jeff Barrett for the lucky bounce interception of the night. A few minutes later, after Canyon got the ball back, QB Vince Titiraga didn't bounce it to Barrett. He threw it to him as the junior linebacker nabbed his second interception of the night and ran it back 20 yards. A major Burroughs penalty during the return took the ball back to the 39-yard line, but Indian QB Lauren Salmon simply sent the ball sailing through the air and into the hands of Keith Jarbo for a 12-0 halftime lead. The Burroughs Indians went on to a decisive 32-7 victory against the Cowboys, the first Indian win in a Foothill League opener in 4 years. Head coach Keith New couldn't have been happier about his coaching that night or his sideline pass-receiving sideshow. While Burroughs was beating the weakest Santa Clarita team, the Burbank Bulldogs were taking on the defending CIF Division III champions in week one of league play at Memorial Field. Hart Indians QB Kyle Matter put on a show, completing 30 of 39 passes for 361 yards and 6 touchdowns. Bulldogs quarterback Paul Escobar didn't have a bad night either, despite the lopsided score. In the fourth quarter, during the Bulldogs' only touchdown drive, Escobar connected with junior tight end Brian Ayers. Then he dumped off a pass to junior receiver Roger Starkey, and on the next play, Escobar hit Starkey again, this time with pinpoint precision. The impressive drive was capped off when Escobar found Starkey for a 16-yard touchdown. as the Bulldogs fell to the Hart Indians 45-8. In the second week of league play, it was the Bulldogs' turn to take on the Canyon Cowboys. Early in the game, Burbank quarterback Paul Escobar was picked off by number 42 Colin McNeil, setting the tone for the first half. Canyon QB Vinny Tittaraga then pitched the ball to number 2 Mark Barr, and the Cowboys were up 7-0. A few minutes later in the first quarter, Tittaraga found Colin McNeil for a 3-yard touchdown pass, and the Canyon Cowboys were up 14-0 going into the second quarter. In the second quarter, following a blocked punt, it was Colin McNeil again, running it in from the 3-yard line for a 21-0 Canyon lead. On the ensuing drive, linebacker Ricky Galvin picked off a Paul Escobar pass and ran 23 yards for a touchdown, as the Cowboys went on to beat the Bulldogs at Memorial Field 49-22. Up Interstate 5 in Santa Clarita, the Burroughs Indians held a 7-6 lead at halftime against the Saugus Centurions. In the third quarter, Keith Jarbo, who ended up with 9 receptions for 139 yards, fumbled on this play, seemingly shifting the momentum. But the shift lasted about 2 plays when Centurion QB Chris Alheim threw up a wounded duck to a falling receiver, leading to this interception by Indian defensive back Marvin Lowry. And with a 7-6 lead and 6 minutes to go in the third quarter, the Indians sensed they might win their second consecutive league game. But when this third down bomb from Lauren Salmon to Jonathan Overturf fell incomplete, the momentum shifted for good.
Slip inside of him! Hey, get inside of him! We worked on that all day Wednesday!
This 7-yard run by Centurion running back Brandon McCullough made it 12-7 Saugus going into the fourth quarter. Burroughs fumbled the ensuing kickoff, setting up the Centurions' McCullough to power in from the 11-yard line. It was 19-7 Saugus early in the final quarter. But the Indians came alive again when Salmon pitched to diminutive running back Marvin Lowry, who tossed the ball downfield into the arms of a wide-open Keith Jarbo. But 6 plays later, Salmon looked deep for Jarbo, but the often double-teamed standout wide receiver watched number 3 Andrew Gutierrez intercept the ball in the end zone. Then Centurion's QB Chris Alheim wasted no time going deep, this time to number 9 George Koval, setting up a 1-yard quarterback sneak by Alheim and a 26-7 Centurion lead with 3.5 minutes to play. With about a minute to go and the outcome not in doubt, things turned a little ugly.
You're going to get him killed! You've got to hold it! Protect the players, man! Hey, protect our players, please!
A few seconds later, Burroughs quarterback Lauren Salmon had enough protection to find Keith Jarbo for this 15-yard touchdown pass, as the Indians fell to Saugus 26-15 and to 1-1 in the Foothill League. It was the Valencia Vikings homecoming and a carnival atmosphere that greeted the Burbank Bulldogs in week 3 of Foothill League play. The Bulldogs came out unfazed by the Ferris wheel, the camel, the monkey, and the elephant, as Paul Escobar hooked up with Roger Starkey for 20 yards on the first play from scrimmage. Escobar found Starkey again, and the Bulldogs were on the prowl for the lead. Escobar then pitched the ball to number 44, Joel Hernandez, and the Bulldogs were up 6-0 4 minutes into the contest. But just as quickly as Burbank had scored, Valencia quarterback Kyle Bauer hit 6'2", 200-pound senior wide receiver Will Broudis for a big gain deep into Bulldog territory. But the tough Bulldog defense stopped the Vikings on fourth down, and Burbank's confidence was bolstered. But just a few minutes later, Bauer looked to Broudis again, this time for a 40-yard touchdown and a 6-6 tie. But the Bulldogs weren't going to roll over to the team that beat them 70-7 last year, as Escobar hit tight end Brian Ayers, followed up by this run by 230-pound junior Mike Baker, who led the team in rushing against Valencia with 58 yards on 15 carries.
Excellent extra effort.
But with the score tied at 6-6 and 9 minutes to go in the half, it was Bauer to Broudis again, this time for a 43-yard touchdown and a 14-6 Valencia lead. A couple of plays later, the Bulldogs fumbled and Valencia recovered. On their first play after the turnover, the Vikings wasted no time going deep to number 6, Nick Scott. That set up a 5-yard Mark Stockton touchdown and a 22-6 Viking lead. And then with 9 seconds to go in the first half, Valencia quarterback Kyle Bauer somehow found number 25 Giovanni Lampignamo as the Vikings upended the Bulldogs 51-14. In week three of Foothill League play, the Burroughs Indians took on the Hart Indians, the number 5 ranked team among CIF Division III high schools. There were very few highlights for the Burroughs Indians, who fell to Hart High School 35-8.
Read the keys. Read your keys.
Same thing.
Fundamentals right now. Let's go.
Hart's number 11, Kyle Matter, the Stanford-bound quarterback, passed for 321 yards and 4 touchdowns. The following week, Burroughs was at home again, this time taking on the Valencia Vikings. This extra point with 2.5 minutes to go in the third quarter put the Vikings ahead 28-7. Later in the third, Valencia's Craig Peters took a Kyle Bauer handoff but was hit by Burroughs' Daniel Hitt, causing a fumble recovered by Keith Jarbo. On the next play, Lauren Salmon dropped back and nonchalantly connected with Jarbo as time was running out in the third quarter. But with less than 20 seconds on the clock, Salmon looked deep for Jonathan Overturf, but overshot his target and was almost picked off. That didn't make Salmon gun-shy, though. On the next play, he unleashed a bomb to Keith Jarbo, who was triple-teamed, but miraculously came down with it for a 44-yard touchdown on the last play of the third quarter. But with about 3 minutes to play, Valencia's Kyle Bauer threw a pass that looked a lot like Jarbo's reception in the third. A double-team Mark Stockland was in the right place at the right time, right after Jonathan Overturf tipped the ball. Valencia beat Burroughs 35-13 as the Indians were 1-3 in league play going into the battle for Burbank. For the past 8 seasons, the Burbank Bulldogs have been 0-4 going into the battle for Burbank. And if they didn't beat the Saugus Centurions at College of the Canyons, they knew that 0-4 record would rear its ugly head again. The Centurions jumped out to a 6-0 lead and the Bulldogs couldn't seem to get the passing game going, although quarterback Paul Escobar was scrambling and rushing for some big yards. On third and long and down 6-0, Escobar did it again, taking the offense into his own hands on the strength of his legs. Escobar did complete a pass or two in the first half, like this one to junior wide receiver Jake Bryan. But in the second quarter, Saugus QB Chris Elheim connected with number 2 Tim Carter, who somehow stayed in bounds and found his way into the end zone. Saugus went on to beat the Bulldogs 25-14. Next stop for the 0-4 Dogs, the battle for Burbank.
Due to Veterans Day, the battle for Burbank was not played on Friday, but Thursday night, November 9th. And besides the game, the build-up to the so-called city championship is always filled with teenage tomfoolery and hijinks. On Monday night, 72 hours before the big game's kickoff, the two teams held an eat-off. 4 players from each team would pig out for an hour on Santoro submarine sandwiches for the Who's the Biggest Glutton bragging rights for the year.
There are some rules, okay, in that they must eat individually, okay, 95% of the sandwich. 2-1-0. Eat!
Come on! Matt Jackson, number 2. D-lineman. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Kyle Fitzgerald, number 71. I'm a center.
Oh, yeah!
I'm Rick Rogers, number 70, defensive tackle.
My name is George Quayle. I play offensive line and number 50.
Yum, yum, yum!
Sean Wood, I play outside linebacker for Burbank High School. We're going to beat Burroughs this year, I guarantee it. But I don't know about the sandwich thing. My name is Maddie Miranda, I play D-line, and we're going to beat Burroughs this year.
Angel Arcos, right guard, number 75.
My name is Brandon Phillips, and I am number 74. I play defensive end, run, go down!
Chug, 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 chug.
Burroughs won the eat-off, 14 sandwiches to 12. But it was the football bragging rights on the minds of Coach Noop and Coach Childress when Burbank Magazine handed them a microphone a day before the battle for Burbank and asked them to do a little Ricky Lake for us.
All right, we're here today with Coach Childress. The game is tomorrow night. I've got Kevin Foy with me tonight. He's got a few words of wisdom for us. Kevin?
How are you guys? We're here from Burbank. You know, we're the better team because we have the better players and our coaches prepared us better. And that's all I got.
That's right. The coaches prepared us better. Remember that, guys. All right, we've got Mr. Holtz with us tonight. What do you got to say?
Yeah, last year the Burroughs coaches said we're not strong enough in the second half, and we're better than last year, and I hope they think that because we're a much better team.
Yeah, Nope, we ran that, by the way. We're not physical enough in the second half. We ran that all week long. They're physical this year. All right, we have Garrett Dahlia with us.
I think we're going to win tonight because, one, we're better, and, two, and it's about time we get a win in.
I think it's been like 8 years since the last win. This is where it stops. And my quarterback this year is Paul Escobar. He's got a few words of wisdom.
Yeah, the first win since 92. It'll be a lot of fun. Everyone should come out there, support us, have a lot of fun, and beat Burroughs.
All right, these are the captains for tomorrow's night's game. We're ready. We've been waiting for this for a long time. We're the best we've ever been, and it's going to be a good game.
Hi, my name is Keith Noop. I'm the head football coach here at John Burroughs High School, and we have the big game tomorrow, Thursday. It's for the city championship, Burbank versus Burroughs, and I'm going to ask some of the Burroughs senior captains, okay, what they think about the game tomorrow, and I'm going to start here with Keith Jarbo to my right. And Keith, the Bulldogs seem pretty confident that they're going to knock us off tomorrow and end the streak at 7 years and start their own streak at one. I've heard rumors that they were going to completely take you out of the game. That was one of the ways that they're going to that's one of the ways they're going to win and stop the streak. What do you think about that?
Basically, I don't think they can do that. We have double threat, and it's myself and then Jonathan Overturf and our other receivers, and Lauren Salmon gets the ball around, and we're going to try and pound them with the run and then go to the pass. And if they try and stop me, then we'll get them with the run. So either way, we'll come out on top.
All right, and then the other threat that we have over here, Jonathan Overturf, another receiver, they seem to think that he's not the threat that the rest of the team thinks, and that they don't need to double cover him. And if they leave you single covered, what are you going to do about that tomorrow night?
All I have to do is just catch the ball, and they cannot stop me. That's about it.
All right. You're going to score. How many touchdowns are you going to score tomorrow night?
At least two.
All right. Okay, and then the talking to some of the Bulldogs, they seem to think that their offense is pretty powerful. And to my left here, we got a couple of defensive starters. All these guys have been on the varsity for 3 years since they were 10th graders, and they feel they're pretty big up front and that they're going to move our defensive guys around. I'm going to start over here with David Holmes, our little guy that's going to be playing a bunch of different positions. I'm pretty sure they're going to come after you because you're not that big. And what do you think about that?
I think I'm just going to use my speed and quickness and just try and juke their linemen and get to their quarterback.
Yeah, you don't think that they're skilled enough to block you?
No, I think I can use my shakes and get on.
All right, that's what I like to hear. Okay, and then next is our captain defensive player, middle linebacker. He's going to be in the mix of everything. I'm pretty sure they got their number on number 44, especially with a name like yours, yeah. Middle linebacker, Daniel Hitt. How are you going to stop the Bulldogs tomorrow night and continue the streak at 8 years?
Well, personally, I think they have no chance against Burroughs. And with me and my defense, we're just going to knock all their heads off, so they better not come my way.
All right. Okay, that's a few words from the Burroughs seniors, and most all four of them are 3-year starters, and they know nothing but winning against Burbank, and I don't think they're willing to start to change now in their senior year. All right, go Burroughs.
The morning of the battle for Burbank, both schools held their annual big game pep rallies, and from the looks of things, there was no shortage of school pride.
Who's going to shut the dogs out? You are. The Burbank Bulldogs up there have been talking a lot of confidence. Okay, they think that this is going to be the year that they stop the streak. But this year is going to be the continuance of the streak. And after tonight, it'll be 8 years in a row that the Burroughs Indians beat the Bulldogs.
Taking it like a joke, even if they pray to the Pope. The concept of Burroughs defeating the dogs is so funny I forgot to laugh. I heard they can't even pass, but when they lose, I'm gonna give them a cookie because their quarterback looks like a rookie. These guys are smaller and dumber, and when they heard the dogs coming, they started running for cover. I heard before games, they all go paint their nails. The receivers are so slow, I could have sworn they were snails. Burroughs is so mixed up, their defense is making the touchdowns, and their offense don't got sense. Pride is all we got, pride is all we need, but if they think it's gonna be easy, we got more tricks up our sleeves.
Yeah.
Both teams had engaged in a little hype and hyperbole the week leading up to the big game. Now only homecoming remained for the two schools before the battle for Burbank commenced. Coin flip would determine who got the ball first, but a deck of 52 cards might have been more appropriate. As the Burbank Bulldogs entered this 52nd battle for Burbank, they brought with them 52 straight losses in league play. Their last league victory was in 1992 against the Burroughs Indians.
All right. Drop it, we'll do it again.
Tails!
Okay, tails is what he called. It's heads.
You want to receive, you want the ball.
Burroughs won the toss and would get the first play from scrimmage. And we couldn't help but recall what they did last year on the first play of the game. This Joe Kroll's to Jonathan Overturf 83-yard bomb for a touchdown. Well, this year, quarterback Lauren Salmon pitched to tailback Michael Perez, who fired it back to Salmon. Salmon jotted deja vu on the ball, then let it rip. Speed merchant Jonathan Overturf would do it again, this year a 76-yard touchdown pass reception, as the Indians were off to a very early 7-0 lead.
And tell them every stinking year! Every stinking year!
Let's go.
That was a nice play, though, wasn't it?
Hey, keep battling up, baby.
I'll give them that trick play. We'll give them that one.
I knew it would work.
It was now the Bulldogs' turn, as quarterback Paul Escobar offered up a perfectly thrown pass to the seemingly always open Roger Starkey. That pass set up this one-yard run by Garrett Dahlia, and the battle for Burbank was tied 3.5 minutes into the game.
All right, let's play some football! Let's do it! Let's play some ball, boys!
Good job, Sal.
Let's play some ball now!
On the ensuing kickoff, junior Michael Perez showed why he's one of the stars of the Burroughs Indians, blowing by everyone on the field for an apparent touchdown. A holding penalty on the play, though, nullified the run back. With 6 minutes to go in the first quarter, part-time Burroughs quarterback Marvin Lowry kept the ball and was surrounded by six white jerseys. But the 5'8", 165-pounder bounced off the Bulldogs, kept his balance, and was gone. The 47-yard touchdown and a J.B. Meyer extra point put the Indians up 14-7. Late in the first quarter, Salmon connected with Jonathan Overturf for 24 yards and a first and goal from the 6-yard line. The catch put slightly shaken up Overturf at a game-high 101 pass-receiving yards.
We got to score. We have to score this drive.
Go off,
no choice.
With about a minute to go in the first quarter, the Burroughs line gave Michael Perez plenty of daylight, and the Indians looked like they might run away with it, leading 20-7.
No, the trap was on my side.
Let's go. Our right, your option left. It's third down and about one and a half.
In the second quarter, Marvin Lowry tried to fake a handoff to number 25, Bobby Mendoza, but got crossed up and fumbled. And the ball was recovered by the Bulldog, Sean Wood.
Defense!
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 That's the break we need. That's it. That's the one. That'll do it. That's the break. Let's do it now. Play smart ball. Smart ball.
It was third and eight from the Indians' 11-yard line when Southpaw junior QB Paul Escobar thread the needle of junior wide receiver Jake Bryan past the outstretched arms of Marvin Lowry and Jonathan Overturf. And with 7 minutes to go in the half, it was only a 6-point Burroughs lead, 20-14, and the scoring by both teams was just getting started.
That was good. That was perfect. That was perfect. Excellent throw.
When we cover three, how do we get the guy get outside of us?
Get over here. Don't walk. Don't walk. Cover three. How does a guy get outside you on the end zone?
I thought they were going to number two coming on the inside.
Is that your man?
Don't think. Get to your deep third.
The Bulldogs regained possession later in the second quarter with the hopes of taking the lead. But junior running back Oscar Flores fumbled at his own 9-yard line, and defensive lineman Gus Rodriguez recovered deep in Bulldog territory. And with 4:25 to go in the half, Bobby Mendoza barreled in from the two, and it was 26-14 Indians. But the Bulldogs weren't going to roll over. With a minute 22 to go in the first half, junior running back Michael Baker, behind some solid blocking, rambled into the end zone. And it looked like the Bulldogs would go into the locker room only down 26-21. But with only 60 seconds on the clock and on their own 45-yard line, the Indians dumped the ball off to the most dangerous man on the field, number 32, Keith Jarbo, who delivered a stiff arm, broke tackles, and stayed in bounds, all with the greatest of ease, ultimately heading for the sideline to stop the clock. With less than 20 seconds in the half and the ball in the 23, tight end Alex Zubia made a circus catch and ran the ball to the 2-yard line as the clock ticked down to 8.
Listen.
Go for a quick pass and then just
hey, let's do this. Let's do this. Here we go. Let's go. Let's do this. No. Let's go. I. You go to X. Okay. Fade to Jarbo. Next play, run up to the line and let's go 2X. Okay, here we go.
Then Lauren Salmon tossed one up for Keith Jarbo, who was one on one with Jason Burton, an almost impossible assignment. But there was one more play to demoralize the Bulldogs, a 2-point conversion, Salmon to Jarbo. And it was 34-21 at halftime.
Don't get down. We're not down that bad. I know the type of heart you got because I've seen you do it. Second half's our half this year. So let's get out there, get it together, play smart, no more penalties the rest of the half. If you get held, you get held, all right? Deal with it. Keep yourself in the game. Don't let them take you out.
Walking behind the Burbank players coming in, and they're like, oh, come on, keep your head up, man, it's okay. Okay, they're defeated, okay? But you know what? Let's step on them. You're gonna smash them, you're gonna block them. Don't run by white jerseys. The jersey's coming by, you block him. Okay, let's bust a couple open here. Second half on three. 1, 2, 3,
second half! Defense on three. 1, 2, 3,
after the kickoff to start the second half, the Bulldogs, who were down 34-21, were not demoralized at all. In fact, they put together an impressive 6-minute drive of assorted runs and passes, and 12 plays later, Paul Escobar hooked up with tight end Brian Ayers for the only score of the third quarter. And it was still anyone's game, with Burroughs leading by only 6 points, 34-28.
Oh, my God.